one of the things about being a teacher, sometimes it can feel like a bit of a thankless job, but when you see someone that you taught 5 years ago who's grown up so much and come back and share their story about how much I was able to impact their lives, that really is a special moment in a teacher's lives. You're not in teaching for accolades, you're in teaching to help students become adults, to help them become responsible members of society. And to hear people come back and say how much I was able to help them reach their goals, that's really special and exactly what every teacher strives for. So that in itself was worth the event, but to see the family, the parents of those students, and to see the siblings of those students, and to see so many other people come out, it was just a really humbling experience. Energy level is definitely the biggest part. I definitely am an active person and spend a lot of time moving and exercising and wrestling with my son. And the energy level has been the toughest part. The chemotherapy, I would say the first round was not bad at all. The second round was tougher. The third round was not pleasant at all. So I expect that the more rounds of chemotherapy I'm on, the more challenging it will get physically. But right now, I would say the hardest part is the emotional toll of knowing that I'm not able to do all the things that I used to do, both physically and helping with my family. So I would say the emotional toll at this point has been more impactful than the physical toll, but I expect that that will level out as the treatment goes a little further along. I've never really felt like a celebrity before, but I think today is the closest thing I'm gonna get to feeling like a celebrity, where everybody that I came across today were family members, friends, former students, current students, which by the way, current students, to be going to prom last night and then waking up early on a Sunday morning to come out is just a tremendous testament to their support. Really, really cool to have this many people out that are willing to share their time, to share their experiences and just come together for a really good cause, and it means a ton to me. So there's a say, a catchphrase that I used to have at the bottom of my email, that I have been fortunate. I've not had a lot of adversity in my life up to this point. I've had struggles like everyone has, but nothing life-threatening up to this point. And one of my credos, greatness is not born, it must be earned. And in the face of adversity, we're given the opportunity to rise up, surpass our greatest expectations, and discover what we're truly capable of achieving. And I truly feel like this is a test for me to figure out just what my mental toughness is and my physical toughness. And this is my opportunity to show that I'm a strong person, that I can overcome this really tough illness, and have no doubt that when the dust is settled, that I'll be here and cancer will be a thing of the past.
Definitely, when I found out about the diagnosis, it's something I've thought about almost daily since then. My brother's somebody that I lived with for a long time after college. I taught with him right across the hall from each other. I coached with him. So, he's kind of my mentor, my role model, and to think of him going through something like this has been on my mind quite a bit. But also, I'm very confident because I know Ryan very well that he's going to take care of this. It all happened pretty quick because I guess we've really only been planning it for about 3 months or so. A lot of help from volunteers, especially all the teachers at Quakertown Community High School. Tons of families, cross-country families that helped out. A lot of my family members and Ryan's wife's family members helped out. So I would say it's been a pretty constant task for about the last 2 months, but usually when you plan a race this big, it takes 6 to 8 months to plan. So we kind of had to cram it all into 2 months, but it's been a busy 2 months. Uh, The race has been great. It's just something that I want Ryan to really be able to think back to and reflect on. He's got a pretty tough road. So, you know, I hope on his tough days he can think back to today and think about the hundreds of people around him that are here to support him, just the fact that he has a lot of people in his corner. When I checked registration this morning, there was about 680 people registered. And then I think we had about another 100 or so show up just to support, volunteer, and register on race day. So I would think we had to have had around 800 people here overall.